Hello, my dear friends. Today we're off to the cult castle again to do an EVP session. And on the way, I spotted this wonderful old house. I just love those green shutters. And the house had such an energy, such a calming energy. I had to stop and film it. Just wonderful, isn't it? The original windows, I can see that's all old, you know, sort of wavy bubble glass. When I say bubble glass, with the little bubbles in them, you know that's been hand blown. Fantastic. And as I was filming, I just thought it was so wonderful with the hill at the back. What a wonderful view they have. And as I was just about to put the camera away, this little kid popped his head out the door. You'll see him there. And he had such a big grin from ear to ear. I think he was so happy that someone loved his home or admired his home as much as he did. And we shared a big smile before I drove off. No words, just, you know, he was happy that someone passed by and thought the house was cool enough to film. So, onwards we journey. A little bit of a different angle from the old greenhouse now. That must have been the servants' quarters, I would imagine, and the door leads out straight into the greenhouse, which I find great. You know, they can go and pick the veggies in the morning. Yeah. Again, this time I didn't see anybody, not even the old man. Don't know where he was. Probably running up and down the staircase, no doubt. Yeah, and these beautiful old stables, aren't they fabulous? Aren't they fabulous? I love it. I love this whole area. You have to imagine it's just like these little tiny roads you can drive up right through the hills. Just beautiful. Really is. There's a few cyclists. No wonder it's such gorgeous scenery. So peaceful. And there's the wonderful castle. I love that place. Love it. I want it. Now, while here, I conduct an EVP session and The first one I do is just with a digital recorder, a personal, Panasonic personal digital recorder. It's the purest EVPs you can get, really. Wasn't the ideal conditions. It was quite windy, although it's a beautiful spring day. The flowers are out. It was quite windy. Not ideal. The best way, actually, is to do it in the quietness of an interior of a house, you know, without any sort of ambient noise. But there was absolutely no one around, no person around that could have spoken into the digital recorder that it would have picked it up. And it did respond, a female voice, as you will hear, quite eerie. It was like she was sort of chanting or saying a hymn. And even as I was talking, she was still chanting over the top of me. Couldn't make out what she said. I stretched the EVP a bit to try and make it a bit more clear. Still hard to make out. So you hear my voice sounding very strange. It's because I stretched it out trying to clean up the audio. And the final one, I asked, what is your name? I asked, what is your name? And I got a reply. I've tried all sorts. The noise around the birds and the wind are just impossible to clean it up that much without erasing the voice. But she appears to have said either Dorothy or Dorothea or you're a thief. The last reference might mean the fact that I was trespassing on the property and she might have assumed that I was coming there to steal something. On reflection, I've actually left the one out where I asked the person's name. Although I can hear a voice definitely on there, the ambient noise in the background is so bad. It's impossible, really. And most people here would just think it sounds like birds and wind and, you know. So I left it out. I know there is a voice on there. And I just played back another part of it. I also heard the same woman saying something else, but it's just, you know, it's just in future, I'm just going to have to do them if I'm inside with the personal recorder I'm talking about, not with the ghost box, but with the personal recorder, I'll just have to do it inside a building because the ambient noise really does, because some of these EVPs are very faint. Some of them are quite clear, but some are faint. And if there's any wind or bird noise, or traffic, aeroplane noise. It just really wrecks it. So anyway, there's quite a few interesting ones to come, nevertheless. And the final ones, I'm going to give my opinion beforehand, before each EVP, what I feel about it. I think that'll probably be better to help you to understand. And I might loop it once, twice, or thrice. Before that happens, any of you out there who are frightened of EVP sessions, you'll know when to turn off, and that's now. Okay? All right, let's go with this. You ready? Now, the next voice up I recognize. He also speaks again. He or she speaks again during this EVP session. The same voice was also at Sarah's grave. My regular viewers will remember that video. I'll put it up in the description, the link. And always speaks my name. You will hear now the communication following. The following voice, I had to slow down, it was so rapid, and he appears to be saying, help me save some. Not sure what exactly means by that. If he is some sort of guide and he wants to help the others, does sound a bit eerie, but that is because it's been slowed down. I will leave it to you to decide. The next one is a young lady's voice. At first I thought she was saying, I'm effed, but now I've deciphered it as, I'm frightened. Let me know what you think. Next I ask the spirits how many of them are seeking the light, and immediately I received an answer in the Swiss-German dialect, Siebenza, which means 17. Listen to this. And during it, I ask a few times, and they answer differently each time as to how many of them need help. And almost immediately afterwards, another spirit voice answers in a Scottish accent, 7. Which may indicate there are different groups of them who, yeah, there may be sort of congregating groups, and they're saying how many there are in the group. I don't know for sure, but listen to this. And the next one appears again to be a Scottish accent, and excuse my attempt at it, but I think he's saying, and a poor victim, and a poor victim. Let me know if you think that's what he's saying. I've listened to it many times. That's all I can figure out. And here once again is the same voice who mentions my name, as he did previously at the start there, and also at Sarah's grave, and he says, it's Oddie. Again, I ask how many of them are seeking the light, and I get the immediate reply, 81. And so quick the replies, it's like they're anticipating your question. And again, the same voice from before saying, "Oddie's here." I'm now telling them here that tomorrow, the next day, I will be helping quite a few of them to get through to the light, and that they could gather the next day, which I did, and immediately someone replies, "Help us." I think the next spirit is saying, "And tell us." Not exactly sure. He may be referring to let them know when I will be conducting, the session to help them through, which I did the next day. They know that I have a quiet place where I meditate and help them to go through. I feel them gather around me as I'm about to do it. They let me know they're there, and I feel them also going through. It's sometimes quite tiring for me to do so, but I've helped spirits pass through for many years. Back when I was younger, it was involuntarily. It used to freak me out, but it was just something that I could do. I didn't have any choice then. Now I do. Now I can help them go through when I'm ready. Some of them try to attach, unfortunately. And stay attached to me, and that's not allowed. But in earlier times they did that, and you figure these things out as you go along, but I only want to help them. Unfortunately, there are some negative ones who don't want me to help the others. They're just like on Earth. There's nasty people who are trying to control others, and if you try to help them, they will try their best to stop you. That's the way it goes, unfortunately. And the next one tells me he can see me. It may be like a situation where we can see ghosts sometimes, and most of the time we can't see them. So it's quite possible in the spirit world they can't see us, but during the EVPs they can hear us, or hear the person who is talking to them. But this spirit seems to be able to perceive me. The Spirit Box app that I'm using, the SONO X12, when you're playing it in real time, you may occasionally hear a word lucidly and you'll understand what it is. Most of it sounds gibberish. As I mentioned in the Sarah's Grave video, I have to put this through the Audacity, and I have to mostly I have to slow it right down. Sometimes I'll have to reverse it to make sense, and do it in different pitches, because they appear to speak very rapidly. Extremely rapidly. I explained all this in Sarah's Grave. Go and watch that video if you didn't. If it's your first time watching, you won't understand this. But if you buy the app and download it, it won't make much sense. You have to put it through to get the most out of it through the Audacity. And I explain in Sarah's Grave how to do that. A word of caution, though. I do not advise you using these apps or anything like that to communicate with spirits if you don't have protection. Study it online, how to protect yourself, and if you're scared, don't try it at all. You may get an entity attached to you. It may follow you home. It may in some way possess you, and can be really debilitating. You know, you may not even notice it, but it will be in you. You'll start to feel tired, irritable. Your health will start to suffer, and you'll feel nervous. And if many attach to you, it can seriously affect your health, I'm telling you. And it can cause psychological problems and all sorts of things you do not want and do not need in your life. So I do not advise you to do this unless you know what you're doing. Okay, my friends, well, that's it for the EVP session today. I hope you've enjoyed the journey with me and the session, if you're still here after all that. And now we might look at the odd vehicle of the month. I stumble upon these vehicles when I'm out and about on my travels, and I always like to share them with my viewers. So here we go. Well, if I owned a castle, this car would be a must. This 1950s British Bentley, isn't it gorgeous? I love it. I love the colouring too, the two-tone. Beautiful. Yeah, I was driving by, spotted this, though I had to stop and check this out. This is an Audi car indeed. Oh, it's just wonderful. Wonderful. Look at the plush red leather interior. I can imagine me sitting in the back there, being driven from my castle to the gentleman's club. Ha ha ha. Dreaming. Yeah, it's nice, isn't it, though? Oh, I bet that loves the petrol, though. Isn't that fantastic? I had to actually step out onto the road to film this. I was just hoping I wasn't going to be squashed by a lorry. Oh, I just love it, man. Hooly dooly. Yeah, that's nice. That's nice. You can keep your modern cars. I just love the beautiful vintage elegance of these old cars. By the way, any of you who are new here will not know that this very castle grounds that I'm in today doing the EVP session, at an earlier time, I was given permission to enter the castle and film it. And I will leave the links to the videos. There's two parts, part one and part two. And part one sort of explains a little bit about the history of the castle and who lived there. And part two is actually the filming of the interior. I'm sure people who love castles will find that very interesting. I'm really one of the only ones that have been allowed into that castle. It's all explained in those videos. I will leave the links in the description, also on the end screen, for those who can see the end screen. It's not visible on all devices. Anyway, my friends, I'm going to head off. I've got some good stuff planned for you guys. Not only out and about, but I'm going to be bringing another historical feature, a brand new one, to you guys. Not only on Patreon, but another one to YouTube too. I'm going to be busy in the next few weeks. Yes, recovering from the demonetization drama. Hopefully everything's back to normal now. God bless you for all your support. Thanks for sticking around. Anyway, my friends, take care and God bless. See you soon.